You will get no credit for either of those sections if you don't do it the way I asked you to do it. And that means you're going to be pulling out your common factor. So when we're subtracting a trinomial, the first thing we're going to do is change the signs high. So every sign just gets changed. And then we come back and add.
Is that only for a trinomial, or can we do that for a
quadnomial, binomial? And what we're doing, we're distributing negative 1. Distributive property of negative 1 times this, negative 1 times that, negative 1 times that. That's literally what we're doing, because there's a 1 right here, and it's being multiplied. But the way I want you to do it is to change your signs high and then add. Okay? Then remember that I have 5x squared and I have plus 2x squared. Now, you can go directly to the fact that you have x squared, you have a 5 plus 2, always a plus sign. You have x's. You have minus 3 and minus 7. Then you have numbers. Always a plus sign. Always a plus sign. Then you have numbers. 4 minus 3. Look at the way your work looks. Now, some of you grouped them first. You wrote 5x squared plus 2x squared. That's okay if you did that. But notice that the reason you put the x squareds next to each other is because they had x squareds. So if instead you can take the common factor and put their numeric, you know, their numeric coefficients, that's what these are, numeric coefficient of this term is 5. The numeric coefficient of this x squared term is plus 2. If you can think of that as you're taking the common factor and putting the numeric coefficients, or the numbers, in parens, very, very common problem. You will definitely see it 2 or 3 times on the final. So we want to make sure we can get this one right. That's what? Minus 10x plus 1. Oh, I'm so happy.